first time ever
WWE premium live event
in Lyon, France.
Hopping across the pond,
hosting the biggest stars in sports entertainment.
Never
the
higher.
Only question is,
can Lyon withstand an event of this magnitude?
Bienvenue tout le monde, welcome to WWE Backlash France. Tonight it is the second pay-per-view of WWE 2K24 Women's Universe Mode, and the superstars are ready to take their rivalries to new heights here in France. The Intercontinental Championship is on the line as Liv Morgan defends against Carmella, who returned at Payback, staking her claim to Morgan and that Intercontinental title, reminding everyone on SmackDown a couple of weeks ago who she is and what she's done here in Universe Mode, and she wants to add the IC title to her long list of accolades. Tensions are rising in the tag division as the titles are on the line in a triple threat elimination tag team match here tonight. KSC2 defending against Damage Control and Toxic Attraction, two former tag team champions. Damage Control want gold back in their faction, and Toxic Attraction want the gold to get back on track. The Evolution title is on the line as Alexa Bliss defends against Zoey Stark. This time last year, Zoey Stark was already Evolution champion in her first year in Universe Mode, and tonight she wants it back. But can Alexa Bliss keep her head in the game as those cryptic teasers finally addressed a star, and it is Alexa Bliss. The Women's World title is on the line as Alba Fyre takes on Becky Lynch. Becky Lynch challenged the champion 2 weeks ago on Raw, and Alba Fyre accepted it very quickly to avoid Asuka and Io Sky. But tonight, did she make a poor decision and will Becky Lynch walk out as champion? The WWE Women's Championship is on the line as Bianca Belair takes on her friend Naomi, who won a gauntlet match 2 weeks ago on SmackDown to earn her way to France here tonight. Two allies will want a fair fight, but who will be the better woman and walk out as the women's champion? And we are kicking things off in a huge way as the Women's World Championship is on the line. Please welcome the man, Becky Lynch. Becky Lynch made it her mission to not spiral to the bottom of the women's division after losing her Intercontinental Championship to Liv Morgan at WrestleMania last year. She started from the bottom and worked her way to the top very quickly. At Clash of the Castle, she became Intercontinental Champion, taking it off of Io Sky but pinning Liv Morgan, which started the longest reign in Intercontinental Championship history at 196 days, which ended at WrestleMania. After Backlash, she called her shot against the Women's World Champion Alba Fyre, saying that she deserves to be in the main title conversation after what she did and the history that she made. She felt that she got overshadowed by another long title reign in the form of Rhea Ripley and the Raw Women's Championship. But Becky Lynch was a main player on Raw, but a lot of people don't see it that way. And with Becky's challenge, we got an unusual acceptance from the Women's World Champion Alba Fyre. Usually challenges don't get accepted that easily, but a returning Asuka and Io Sky were swarming the ring of the Unholy Union 2 weeks ago on Raw, and Alba accepted Becky's challenge. But last week on Raw, Isla Dawn went 1-on-1 with Becky Lynch, and it was Becky Lynch on top. So tonight, could Becky Lynch do the exact same and take the title off of Alba Fyre? Was it a challenge accepted too easily and too quickly in order to get rid of Asuka and Io Sky? They were in the WrestleMania main event. Obviously, Alba Fyre cashed in her contract and became Women's World Champion from Rhea Ripley, her former Judgment Day leader. And they want the Unholy Union to suffer. But Alba Fyre has walked in to another challenge from Becky Lynch. So with the title on the line, could it be Lynch with another title, or will Alba Fyre retain?
Referee signals for the bell, and we've got the arm trapped. Looking for Levi's straw cradle. She gets a quick kick out there. Not yet.
Ooh, man, what a hit.
Turnbuckle's the only thing keeping her upright.
Metal rope forearm on point. Lands a knee.
Drops the hammer.
Right on the lower back.
Shifts that to her favor.
Bump knees into the face.
Oh, what a kick.
Ooh.
The springboard attack fails.
fails to land. Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
And whatever the game plan, it didn't look to work out for Alba there.
And Becky saw an obstacle in her way and handled it accordingly.
Becky Lynch has so many tricks in her arsenal, so many ways to get the better of her opponent. Corey, what do you think is going to be the go-to for her here?
We know that Becky likes to pick up the pace, to throw her opponents off that way. Disorienting and discombobulating the competition is something Becky really excels at and could be the key to her getting the upper hand in this one.
Drop kick!
Great athleticism.
Alba Fyre absolutely ready to take her on here. Devastating elbow. What is she thinking here? DDT! And up the turnbuckles we go. Oh, it's gonna happen.
She certainly took a chance there. High.
Becky Lynch. Hits him! Disarm her!
I can't believe she's hanging on.
Oh, this trap, but she gets away.
Would you look at this? She is removing the turnbuckle pad now.
Responds with a counter.
Looking wobbly in the corner.
Uh-oh. This is not going to be nice. This is going to be nasty.
It's all about winning, no matter what it takes.
Superplex!
The agonizing impact. That may well be a turning point in this match.
Uh-oh.
See the cover. Valuable seconds passing as they're distracted.
She saw that one coming.
Up handle suplex. The champion's down. The champion's down.
Oh my God, we're gonna have a new champion. Lynch with her opponent trapped in the corner and a springboard sidekick connects.
Stomp on the apron.
Whoa, look out!
Running bulldog!
Oh, clothesline!
Setting up for her. Oh, no, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Disarm her. Disarm her.
You feel like hope is starting to...
Slides right out of the disarmer.
Oh, man.
Alba Fyre with all the confidence in the world.
A rope step
to the outside. Tope con hilo. Just a devil-may-care attitude on full display.
Going for broke, and it pays off. Just disrespectful.
And gets tossed back into the mat. Alba Fyre turning to the crowd for assurance. And now she's looking to go top rope.
From the top, drop kick, missile style.
Response to Fyre's up. The man setting her up for the manhandle slam.
We can have a new champion.
Is it enough? The cover. Two count. What a kick out of two.
That was a matter of a fraction of a second.
You know, Becky is feeling a dissatisfaction with the outcome of that pin count. She thought she had it. Monster set up in the corner. Big time move coming up. Good timing with that reversal.
Somehow she's still in this matchup. It's unbelievable. From the middle,
from the middle, to retain the title.
Now is not the time to wallow in disbelief. Pressure must be kept on.
From the top.
Target in the stomach to reverse that maneuver.
Alba Fyre digging deep into the arsenal here. The Goring Bomb. A championship level move.
For the win. Two.
Alba Fyre.
In a very back and forth, hard fought match between Becky Lynch and Alba Fyre, Alba retains. A misstep from Becky gets caught in the firebomb. Oh, wait a minute. There is Io Sky attacking Isla Dawn inside the ring as the Empress of Tomorrow, Asuka. Once again, repeat from Payback. Asuka and Io Sky are trying to take out the Unholy Union. Obviously, upset that they lost at WrestleMania due to the cash-in. And Asuka, Alba dodges. The mist hits Io Sky. Asuka was going for Alba, but she got out of the way, and now Io is the one blinded by Asuka. And now Isla back in the mix, getting the upper hand onto Asuka. Cracking the back of the Empress of Tomorrow, and now the Unholy Union are on top. No more running from Asuka and Io, and no more getting beaten up. The Unholy Union with the Fallen Angel to Asuka. Backlash in France. The Unholy Union get one over on Asuka and Io Sky once again. As Alba Fyre continues to reign. It's like she gives me nothing to do, so I'm not here, and then this happens. Hey, what happens? Oh, I don't know, Dakota. Remember the fact that while Eve was pushing Bailey off of SmackDown and you two were scheming your master plan to get a toxic attraction, I was attacked backstage by that psycho Roxanne Perez. And funny enough, it was Bianca of all people to pull her off of me, but I guess that's not important news. You know what? It's not important. For the fact that, what are we gaining from Roxanne? I don't like her either, but we've stopped her chances of getting a title constantly and you keep poking the bear. The main issue is Bianca, and I see none of you doing anything about that. Roxanne is the reason for Sonya not being the GM anymore. I could still be the women's champion right now if it wasn't for her. What have you done to get at Bianca, huh? Are you serious? All about Bayley and the women's championship. So Bayley gets to sit at home and sulk about not being booked, but we get pushback for getting on with things and getting a tag title match tonight, so we can win back the titles and have gold back in the group. But I guess that's not important news either. So we just let Roxanne. Well, enough about Roxanne. We're gonna win back our tag titles tonight and try and fix this group. So while we do that, you turn your attention back to Bianca, and if you can come up with something, then you can let us know. Because we're not putting our careers on the back burner because some people can't figure out what to do. Tensions are at a high between all members of Damage Control. Upset from Bayley not being able to challenge for the Women's Championship anymore, obviously Sonya got attacked backstage by Roxanne Perez on SmackDown this past week, and Damage Control want to become tag team champions, and obviously Dakota feels that she's being targeted by Sonya Deville, and it's a reel for Bayley and a reel for her and Cora Jade. But speaking of, it is the triple threat tag team elimination match. KC2, the women's tag team champions, are defending against Toxic Attraction, Gigi Dolan and GC Jane, and Damage Control members Dakota Kai and Cora Jade. Now for weeks now, these three teams have been at each other's throats, particularly Damage Control and Toxic Attraction. KC2 won the titles at WrestleMania off of Toxic Attraction, defended them at Payback, and Damage Control, after Bayley is no longer in contention for the Women's Championship, refocused and came up with a new plan to get some gold back in their faction, and they attacked the tag team champions 2 weeks ago on Raw, sticking their claim back to the gold that they lost at Royal Rumble to Toxic Attraction. But GCGN has obviously not let it lie, as she wants the gold back, as she wants Toxic Attraction to get back into winning ways with the gold that they held before. They've been getting involved in each other's matches. Cora lost to Katana last week on Raw, and Damage Control got involved in the tag team match between Toxic Attraction and Bianca Belair and Naomi. So tonight, it is triple threat rules with eliminations. The tag team champions could be eliminated first, and we could be guaranteed new tag team champions. But they also need to keep their head on a swivel, as the rules, it is a tornado tag. So will Toxic Attraction get their tag titles back and stop Damage Control from becoming the Women's Tag Team Champions? Or will KC2 continue on their party as champions?
The champions.
Wait, you're asking Saxton that question? You do realize none of the female superstars talk to Byron, let alone two of them. I hear things, maybe not directly, but I hear them. And from my opinion, the champions are coming into this match possibly underestimating their competition just a little bit.
Corey, what are the perils of this match that superstars must be concerned with?
Well, this is the type of setting where you must beware of outside interference, because when it's no disqualification, it's not considered interference. It's legal.
The match can change in an instant when another individual who is not officially part of the match makes their presence felt.
That's when a competitor needs to utilize the anything-goes stipulation to their benefit and eliminate the mismatch. Agility like that is what can set you apart from the rest of the locker room.
To not even allow a two count at this juncture.
Mat slam
with some attitude.
Now back to Jade.
The champ using every tool they have to protect their lane.
Goes under the ropes to get back inside. And look at this now. Bad intentions coming with his hold.
Almost a miraculous escape and a side slam.
Then we have Katana. Fighting back with a counter.
Kick to the body.
It has been chaos non-stop in this match as JC is taking to Katana chance. No eliminations, no team has been eliminated just yet. Remember, if one person gets out, the entire team is out, and Katana with that hurricanrana from the top rope taking out JC. Katana got a win over Becky Lynch a few weeks ago, the night after WrestleMania, like JC Jean with the roll up to Katana. And JC pins her. We're guaranteed new tag team champions as Dakota Kai with a pump kick. We will have new tag team champions. KC2 are not the champions anymore. They have been eliminated by JC Jean. And I Dakota as Gigi tries to take advantage. Damage Control or Toxic Attraction will get back their tag team gold as Dakota with a roll up to Gigi. And Gigi kicks out. They are both still in the running as Dakota now has her up and drops her. Will Damage Control regain the tag titles? And they've done it. Dakota Kai and Cora Jade are your new tag team champions, getting back the gold they once held and lost at the Royal Rumble. Damage Control have gold back in their faction. Dakota made a statement earlier on tonight to Sonya and Bayley that they weren't going to put their careers on the back burner for the sake of Bayley and the Women's Championship, and now they're new tag team champions. Tonight I get a shot at the Women's title. Now, two WrestleManias ago, I walked in as champion and defended my title successfully, only to be thrown into an impromptu match by the then GM Sonya to take on Bayley. That night I lost my title and I couldn't face being here after. I left, and 10 months later I answered Bayley's open challenge, and that didn't go my way either. But lately things have been shining brighter for Naomi. I helped push Sonya out of her GM position at WrestleMania, and I won a gauntlet match to earn this match tonight. I know Bianca and I have history and are friends, but tonight it's about the best woman winning, and I'm going to give it my all to prove why I was a champion and why I can be again. A lot of history there, a lot of missed history too. Liv, long time no see. Right, I mean, it's been what, over 2 years since we've been on the same brand? I'm not here to rain on your parade, but since you were talking of the past, when you first held that women's title, remember I beat you for it? And then we faced each other at WrestleMania and I won, and yeah, I'm not sure the not raining on my parade is working. I'm not trying to offend, just going down memory lane with you. Look, we were different people back then. Hell, you even had your time on the dark side in order to win back that women's title, so you know how it feels to have it all and lose it too. Now, I'm a champion and you could be again, so no hard feelings and good luck. I mean it. Thanks, I appreciate it. Don't think I'm not going to get you back for all you and your dollhouse did to me. Whoa, like I said, different times. But maybe we can run it back sometime. Well, certainly a blast from the past between Liv Morgan and Naomi. Remember, 2K20, Liv Morgan and Naomi were in a heated rivalry with each other. Liv Morgan turned to the dark side, forming the dollhouse with Mia Yim and Ember Moon, became SmackDown Women's Champion against Naomi at a SummerSlam. They faced each other at WrestleMania, where Liv Morgan came out on top also, but they haven't been on the same brand for ages, as Naomi faces Bianca later on tonight. But right now the Intercontinental Championship is on the line, as Carmella, who returned at Payback, is setting her sights on Liv Morgan and that title. Carmella reminded everyone 2 weeks ago on SmackDown who exactly she is and what she has done. She was a former Evolution Champion. She unified that title with the United States title that Alba Fyre once held. She defeated Alba Fyre years ago. And now she feels that the refresh button has been hit on Carmella and she needs a new championship. But Liv Morgan isn't going to give it up that easily. She worked too hard on Raw against Becky Lynch to capture that gold. And tonight, she wants to put Carmella back into obscurity and forget her accolades, because Liv Morgan is on top.
Has officially begun.
I'm not even sure the word official is in their vocabulary at this point.
I think you're right, Saxton, and I love it. Oh, what an elbow high on the chin. And a slap for the exclamation point. The challenger looked unhinged with an absolutely uncorked attack on the champ there. Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
Oh, putting focus on the arm here.
No, did we just see a tooth fly out?
An agile escape.
What do you think Liv's biggest weakness is going into this match?
Liv's a superstar who feeds off her confidence, but it can veer into overconfidence. Overwhelm her, shake her foundations, and the path to victory will be a lot simpler.
Taking it to the floor, what's she gonna do? Drop kick!
Oh, great height.
Everyone needs to get out of the way of this fight.
This feels so unsafe.
Brought back into the ring from the floor now. Morgan showing no fear up there. Lift off, and she doesn't connect.
And if Morgan wants to reach her potential, she has to avoid that kind of offense.
My beautiful Carmella looking to push the advantage after that.
She turns it right around with a counter.
Ooh, kick to the face.
Here's the pin. Title on the line.
Kick out at one. She likely knew that wasn't enough. She's just keeping the pressure on.
She's on unsteady legs in the corner. Needs to recover.
That turns it around for Carmella.
Being put into knots.
Champ's got the pin to retain. Kick out at one for the challenger.
She shows that she's far from finished.
Morgan gets intercepted.
Planted face first.
And Carmella.
Here's the pin. Title on the line.
Go.
Stopping the ref's count at two.
I didn't think we'd see a kick out there.
Liv is really out of it. She might be done soon.
Carmella with a super kick.
The title's in jeopardy here.
I think the paradigm has shifted. Oh, she's still alive.
Based on what we just saw, I think this match is far from over.
Who knows what that kick out cost? The champ might be running on fumes.
And with that, Carmella's dumbfounded, absolutely dumbfounded as to how that didn't end things.
Tossing out the window, and it paid off.
Adrenaline is through the roof now.
And that was some brutal impact on that DDT.
Counters on counters. Technical prowess on display.
Bulldog!
The jumping complete shot.
Face first.
Another one bites the dust to the champ.
Throws her back in from ringside.
She's going up.
Top rope here.
From the top.
Diving senton. That's gotta be it.
Two.
Oh, I thought the champ had it.
What does she have to do to put her away?
I'm asking myself the same question. I have no idea.
Catches the leg.
A counter answered by another counter. Drop kick.
All the momentum swinging away from Carmella.
Mel's being systematically worked on. Blow after blow, hit after hit. Somehow these women just keep going.
Their drive, their will to keep fighting can't be extinguished.
And it looks like they have no problem bending the rules there.
Going up top.
She's got her in her sights. Incoming. All the way to the outside. Trying to do as much damage as humanly possible.
But at what cost?
And now thrown back into the ring.
Liv throwing caution to the wind and like, wait a minute. Candice, that's Candice LeRae. Causing a disqualification in this match attacking Liv Morgan. Liv has retained the title, but Candice is now attacking the champion. Remember, it was the SmackDown after WrestleMania. Candice wanted to become the number one contender. She wanted a championship match after winning the WrestleMania Battle Royal. And like Carmella, obviously upset that she's lost out here tonight because of Candice. Candice wanted that shot that Indy Hartwell took from her at Backlash and a DDT to Carmella. The Poison Pixie has had enough of waiting around. She wants that Intercontinental Championship. As we see there, the Evolution Champion Alexa Bliss is getting prepared for her matchup against Zoey Stark coming up next. As, what? The lights are flickering backstage. Whoa, easy. It seems like those cryptic little messages were all for you. Seems like whoever it is finds an easy way to get inside your head. What did you tell Shotzi? Oh, get inside Alba's head and you'll win? Didn't work out for her, but maybe you can figure out a way to stop it. Just don't get too close to the fire. Well, Isla is right about one thing. Those teasers that we've been seeing for weeks now finally did address someone, and they said a moment of bliss And obviously the doppelganger that we saw emerge at Backlash that attacked Alexa Bliss has made their presence felt 2 weeks ago on Raw. Alexa feels that she's losing her mind. Obviously, she had a trip to the dark side for quite some time. She unleashed it at WrestleMania to capture the Evolution title from Mandy Rose. And Alexa Bliss seems to have turned a new leaf, but I don't think the past has forgotten her, and it doesn't want to let her go, whatever it is. But she needs to focus on tonight's task, as Zoey Stark is focused, as she wants to become Evolution Champion once again. Remember, this time last year, she was already Evolution Champion. She became Evolution Champion on the first pay-per-view of Universe Mode against Dana Brooke. She ran Raw as the resident bully as champion, but now Bliss is all out here alone. She doesn't have Toxic Attraction anymore. She is not playing that game with them. She's had mind games played with her. Unusual for her, she's usually the one playing the mind games on other people. But whatever is targeting her, it is certainly not good. And Isla Dawn poking fun at the champion. A lot of history between Alexa and Alba Fyre also. Alexa was also a confidant for Shotzi when she was challenging Alba Fyre a month ago at Backlash. But tonight, can she retain her title?
The champ looks as hungry and prepared here as ever.
Yeah, they have absolutely no desire to even entertain the possibility of walking out of here tonight without their title.
Oh, square shot, but the back elbows ends that. Deep arm drag. Able to reverse.
What's Zoey thinking here?
Oh, God, that looked devastating. And she gets a quick kick out.
Trying to make short order of things there.
Oh, that backfired on her. Slam. Shoulders down for the count and bypasses the pinfall.
This match is not going to end so soon.
Set up in the corner of the ring. One after one in the corner.
The champion just teed off. Our challenger found no way to break free there. Just tearing away on the shoulder here.
There is a fine line between strain and pain. And your shoulder covered by the champ.
And she gets the shoulders up.
Maybe she knew that wasn't going to put her away, but it definitely kept her down for a beat.
Zoey Stark is all about two things, working hard and hitting hard. How does that work to her benefit tonight?
Honestly, Gold Stark just needs to keep doing what she's doing. Do the work, keep the hits coming, and never second-guess herself.
Finds a counter from Stark. Off the arm drag, rolled right into a pinning combination.
And a kick out.
She's trying to get this thing done as quickly as possible.
Uh-oh. Oh, my God, what a move.
Carefully measured knee drop.
Oh, man.
Bliss turns that around. Sunset flip powerbomb.
The champion's intentions are.
Here's the pin. Title on the line. She was close to the end there.
Able to squeeze that shoulder out. So close.
Oh, wiped out with the crossbody. Lined him up. Boom. Knocked him down. Ouch. Kidneys.
Golly.
And Bliss may be thinking of mind games there when she should have focused on physical offense. And pulling the arms up and torturing their opponent.
Ooh, she hit the corner hard.
Punch right to the face. One after one in the corner.
Showing absolutely no mercy at all. What an onslaught.
Driven down face first.
Zoey Stark off the rope.
Zoey Stark going low with a basement knee.
And shoulders are down.
Two.
A kick out before three.
She is still fighting, still keeping this going. Stark looking to wrap this one up.
Zoey Stark on the mark with Z360.
The title might change hands.
Two. Nah, she kicked out.
This is complete insanity. Still holding on to the title by the skin of their teeth.
Is there still enough left to try that maneuver again? Or is her confidence shaken?
Oh, a knee. Lights out. That'll stop you in your tracks.
Turning the tables.
Check this out. What a DDT.
Yeah, good night.
The title's going nowhere. Kiss your dreams. Good night. I don't believe it. How did the challenger survive that?
By the skin of their teeth. And don't expect the champ to start going easy on him now.
And with that, Alexa's now perplexed, now wondering, what will it take? Looking worse for wear in the corner now. The challenger's hopes are slipping away.
Not what you want to see by any...
Oh, my gosh!
Oof! A fucking dropkick to the face!
Great awareness as she proves to be too quick.
Ooh.
What more can any of these women do in this scenario?
You have to squeeze every last ounce out of whatever gas you have left in the tank.
A nice shot by Alexa Bliss.
Alexa showing with authority why you don't want to cross her.
And now she's climbing to the top turnbuckle.
Alexa!
Big mistake there, Corey.
She knows that now.
Oh, jeez. Ooh, she just turned it off.
Check this out. What a DDT.
Yeah, good night.
The champ will stay champ.
Two!
And these two threw everything they had at each other. Finishers were kicked out of, but Alexa Bliss on top, retaining her Evolution Championship against Zoey Stark. I don't know. Not again. These mind games, toying with Alexa Bliss. Alexa, what's your back? There is that thing again. Choking out Alexa, as Alexa's fighting back. She's had some time to get her head around it. I don't think she has just yet, but she's doing anything she knows how. And she's attacking whatever this thing is, this doppelganger of Alexa Bliss. They look exactly like Alexa Bliss of old. And like, what the hell? That was a fireball. A fireball to the face of Alexa Bliss. And this thing is choking her out. We hope to have a medical update on Alexa very soon. Now, as GM, I have been looking ahead and constantly looking to what is next, and I can reveal that the next time that we have a pay-per-view, it will be the Queen of the Ring. The tournament returns after missing last year. Now, back in 2K20, the first Queen of the Ring took place, with our current WWE Women's Champion Bianca Belair winning it first. Then, Bayley became our Queen of the Ring the following year. As much grievances as we have, credit where credit is due. Both went on to capture gold and became staple figures here in the WWE. So that has set a precedent, footsteps to follow, which is why whoever wins the Queen of the Ring will not only earn the title of Queen of the Ring, they will also earn a championship match at our following pay-per-view, SummerSlam. The bracket will be revealed on the upcoming Raw, with matches taking place each week to build our finals. The winner will challenge their respective brand's main title holder at SummerSlam. Eve, I need a match with Sonya. I don't care if it's tonight or SmackDown or hell, even NXT, but I need to get my hands on her again. Roxanne, relax. Look, I know the anger she has caused you, and I was informed about what happened on SmackDown backstage, but I didn't want to reveal anything, but I've placed you in the Queen of the Ring tournament, so if you were to advance, your matches would be already decided. Well, is Sonya in it too? Give me her in the first round. Excuse me, coming through. I hear a tournament set for a queen is coming, and as we saw at WrestleMania, I defeated the self-proclaimed queen, so really, I should just be given the title match. Oh, Roxanne, my pint-sized gremlin. This tournament is for queens only, and if you saw what Trishy and I did to Charlotte this past SmackDown, then you'd know you have no chance. So maybe just go back to preschool and leave this to the grown-ups. Whoa! No more talking, Tiffany, as Roxanne is fed up with you, too. Not queen-like behavior, Roxanne. Well, the Queen of the Ring is our next pay-per-view, but tonight we are not done with Backlash France, as the Women's Championship is on the line. The EST Bianca Belair is defending against her friend, Naomi. It is the main event of Backlash, and the WWE Women's Championship is on the line. Now, Naomi has been having a slight rise here on Universe Mode. She returned at Vengeance Day last series, answering an open challenge from Bayley. She was unsuccessful in capturing the SmackDown Women's title. However, she went on to WrestleMania to team up with Roxanne Perez and Sasha Banks to take down Damage Control and cost Sonya Deville her GM position. 2 weeks ago on SmackDown, she ran a gauntlet match to earn this match. She pinned a number of superstars in that match. She pinned Dakota Kai, Charlotte Flair, and ultimately Sonya Deville to win the entire thing and earn this match against Bianca Belair. She's had Bianca's back in the past. They were Team Bad members years ago with Sasha Banks. She obviously turned to the dark side, as Liv Morgan mentioned earlier on, to win the SmackDown Women's title back from Sasha Banks a while ago. But tonight, she wants to get back some solo gold. They are friends, they are allies, they have had each other's backs in the past, but tonight it is about who is the better woman. And the EST has proven that she is the better woman time and time again against Damage Control, winning the NXT Women's Championship, ending the longest reigning NXT Championship reign in history with Dakota Kai 2 WrestleManias ago, and won the SmackDown Women's title at WrestleMania against Bayley. She has proven time and time again that she can go to the extreme and win. And tonight she wants to prove that she can beat more people than just Damage Control. She wants a fight. She said to Naomi she wants a fight tonight. And Naomi wants a fair fight. It is 1-on-1. No 4-on-1, no sneak attacks will happen in this match between two allies and two friends, with the WWE Women's Championship on the line, and there is the respect, a handshake between the two.
In the ring, and the referee officially starts the match.
Well, this is the way we're starting, Cole. I think the WWE Universe is in for quite a show tonight.
And Atlas offense with a hurtful purpose. Oh. She's got an answer for that.
We know that Bianca Belair uses every moment in the ring to prove herself to EST. You can prepare physically for
from the middle rope.
Nobody home for that one.
Now pick up your teeth and go home.
She's staying elusive.
Big forearm and a clothesline.
To the floor.
Oh, got the knees up. Could be a big turnaround here.
She's sent back in under the ropes. Looking to take flight here. And Belair gets beat.
Here we go. Crossbody.
And into the count. The champion with a quick shoulder up.
Still a ways to go in this match based on that.
Put into the corner now.
Oh, that can flatten you.
She manages to get control.
Swinging the elbow to halt the offense.
Shoulder tackle. Challenger
character's a little worse for wear now.
Yeah, and that could be a building block for Belair to build upon.
Turning the tables there. Oh, look ahead, Cesar. DDT!
Incredible.
Covered by the challenger. She overcomes the pinfall attempt.
Impressive to not even allow a two count at this juncture.
Oh, man. And now she's looking to go top rope. To the sky.
Someone knows that if they want to hold gold at the end of the night, they have to pull out all the stops.
You have to think this match is starting to take its toll.
Stops the kick.
Close line.
Open. Spine buster. Looking for the victory. Two. No. Title still hangs in the balance.
There's some shock in the arena after that kick out.
In front of us.
And how these competitors are still surviving is beyond explanation.
Looking to end this. The schoolboy! Covered by the champ! Oh, and a kick out!
Getting out of that by the skin of their teeth.
Oh, that can squash him. Places her right in the corner. Got her where she wants her. Bianca gets rescinded right back. She scores big with the counter.
Bianca Belair, oh, look at this. Making it look easy. Taking her time.
And a power slam. Belair getting ready. Taking flight. Stand this right now.
Bianca Belair has her up. K.O.D. Can't be. Will the rain continue?
That's gotta be it.
And Naomi gave it her all, but the EST stands tall here at Backlash, still the WWE Women's Champion. Obviously, Naomi's got to be upset that she couldn't get it done tonight. But these two have a bond stronger than that. The handshake between two friends as Bianca Belair is still your Women's Championship here at Backlash. And wait a minute, there's Bayley attacking the champion. Bayley can't even challenge for the Women's Championship anymore. What on earth is she doing out here attacking Bianca Belair? She's had no game plan since she lost at Backlash. She's been sitting at home or whinging to Sonya Deville backstage. And now this is the plan? And Naomi coming back to the ring trying to aid Bianca. And wait, there's Sonya Deville. Damage Control members Dakota Kai and Cora Jade did say that they should come up with a plan to target Bianca because she is the main issue of their problems. And Naomi is fighting back as Bayley is still going on as a champion. Sonya sent into the barricade. And Naomi with a dropkick to Bayley. trying to fend her off as Bailey. Now, taking advantage onto Naomi as Bianca back on the apron, and there is the new Women's Tag Team Champions Dakota Kai and Cora Jade. They said, let us know if you have a plan to target Bianca. And obviously this is the plan. Refocus onto the Women's Champion. Vicious assault to the EST, planting her down. Damage Control have the tag team gold back, and now they seemingly have come up with a plan to target Bianca Belair and Naomi. Is this the resurgence of Damage Control back on top?